Hey you guys, welcome back to our channel, the number one place for people who love design, art and all things creative. You are watching Dantier Balogh's channel, my name is Laszlo, and in this video I want to show you how I have designed Twitch emotes for the first time, right after finding out what Twitch emotes are in the first place. So this video is a little bit of a studio blog, a little bit of a Twitch emote design tutorial, and a little bit of a life lesson on branching out and trying new things as a creative as well. It's gonna be fun. Ready, set, go! So to make sense of this video, I need to start with giving you guys some context. I got this friend who messaged me a couple months ago telling me that he has started a Twitch channel where he does live streamings of himself playing video games, and he's going to need a logo. I was like, great, I don't know much about Twitch, but I know a lot about branding, so talk to me man, what do you have in mind? He then went on to explaining his ideas, what kind of games he is planning to stream, and how Twitch in general is very much like YouTube, except everything is live. And so the videos and the chat and the comments, all of this content creation happens in real time, building this instant, very strong sense of community, which is something that appealed to me straight away. Long story short, I put together a logo for him, this one to be exact. If you wanna know more about the logo concept, check out our Instagram, I made a very nice post about it, but I don't wanna use precious screen time talking about that here. So the logo was done, I have put together some social media banners for him, and after he paid, quite frankly, I thought that's it, I'm never gonna hear about this project ever again. Fast forward a couple months, he messages me again, telling me that now he has become a Twitch affiliate, which besides giving him a little bit of ad revenue on his channel, is now allowing him to further customize the look and feel of his streaming channel as well. So he's gonna need me to design some Twitch emotes. And I was like, cool man, that's fantastic, amazing news. I do have a question though, what are Twitch emotes? And this has opened a full can of worms for me, blowing my mind at the same time. Now if you're part of the Twitch community, this is nothing new to you. But I, as an outsider, was fascinated by the fact that on Twitch, you can customize your emoticons, emojis, which emotes are at the end of the day, to further strengthen your brand, image and style. So after some initial research, I sat down and I started planning out some emotes for his channel. As you can tell, by design, emotes tend to lean on this chibi, cartoony, anime style a lot, which makes sense as these things have to be overly expressive while super simple at the same time, given their extremely small scale. Now most artists tend to go for Photoshop or Clip Studio Paint to put these little designs together, but I thought, you know what? These should be vectors, so I can resize them any way I want later on. Who knows, you might want to make physical merch, like actual stickers or badges out of these one day. So I better start big, then scale down later. My first idea was to create pixel-perfect line-work-based designs, which classic emojis usually are. And then later I can rely on color and shading to dress these up to the desired cartoony look. I mapped out our set of 4 designs and even started coloring in one of them in 2 different ways to show an idea to the client how will this look in the end. So I presented the work to him and he hated it. Yeah. The colors he liked, but the overall look and feel of this very clean and neat line work, he just wasn't on board with. It was too clean, too symmetric, too Android emoji-like, while missing that cool, cheeky, handmade element, which give Twitch emotes their signature flavor. Yeah, all fair points. So we decided to ditch this whole direction and start from zero again. Now this time I thought, instead of this purist vector designer route, I'm gonna go back to my classico Illustrator ways and I'm going to hand draw the basic shapes of these emojis and then put that into Illustrator to create the final line on. Now I have to admit, this sort of anime slash manga style never came naturally to me, so I was somewhat worried what the client would say to this, but as soon as I was done and I showed him the characters, he was 100% on board with them and greenlit coloring straight away. Now I thought to further emphasize this handmade look, I'm gonna need to switch to a pixel-based program, so I did the coloring in Photoshop instead of Illustrator. In terms of technique, I'm not doing anything mind-blowing here. First I fill out the shapes with some solid colors, then I overlay some shadows and lights on top of these color layers. I literally only work with black and white brushes here on top of these new layers, which I have set to overlay mode. Given the simplistic nature of emotes, this would be enough to wrap up the whole project really, but I thought, you know what, let's take things one step further and give them a little more color, just to make them feel a bit more three-dimensional. I go in with some blacks and whites again, this time on a normal layer. So they actually are black and white shades. Nothing major, I keep things very subtle here. And once that is done, I add some colors here and there, just to make the designs pop. This doesn't sound very professional, but all I do here is go on the big color palette in Photoshop and choose a seemingly random shade, which in theory shouldn't work with the initial color scheme, and see what happens if I add some of this color anyway. Like a little bit of green here and there, for example. More often than not, I end up getting somewhere really interesting color-wise with this trick, so yeah, try it yourself. Okay, this is how the final set ended up looking like. And after the client agreeing to them, all that's left to do is saving them out the right way. Now first of all, I took them apart. I think I mentioned this in previous videos how, whenever I'm being asked to work on a set of different designs, I like to work on them simultaneously. You know, to oversee the whole process, just to make sure that they visually resemble each other in terms of the line work and the colors and whatnot. So I did that for this one, and then later on, I took the whole thing apart in Photoshop. Now when you're saving out Twitch emotes, there are a couple things to bear in mind. First of all, these need to be transparent PNGs, so make sure to turn off the white background. And your canvas needs to be a perfect rectangle. Twitch's website states that the size of your rectangle should be between 112 pixels by 112 pixels, and you can go up to 4096 pixels by 4096 pixels. I kept my work to 1000 by 1000 just to make life a little bit easier. At this point it wouldn't hurt to do a little bit of a double check and see how the designs work, you know, without the background. And once you feel like they're all good to go, you can call it a day, package them up, send them off, and done. So I send these over, and if I'm not mistaken, all you really need to do is upload them to your Twitch channel. After which, Twitch actually goes through them, just to make sure that they are up to their standards and rules and whatnot. And usually within a couple of days, you got yourself some custom emojis that your subscribers can use on your channel. It's pretty cool. Now the reason why I wanted to make this video and document my findings in real time, including my mistakes and my research and all that, instead of putting together one of those how to design emotes for Twitch tutorial using Photoshop CC kind of videos, is because I think if you are a young designer or artist, you will get thrown into this kind of situations quite a lot. People will want you to make designs and artwork for platforms that you are not using. Platforms you might never even heard of. And I think it's really easy to get scared, get cold feet, and just turn these projects down by default, thinking that, oh, well, you know what, I don't know anything about Twitch, so you should hire a designer who specializes in Twitch emote design instead. Well, all you really have to do is sit down, pull your sleeves up, and spend an hour or so researching and familiarizing yourself with this new, unheard of thing. Like, I'm not much of a gamer, I don't really play video games, let alone watch other people play on streams. But for me it was quite a nice, comforting realization that my illustrative style actually works for this emote format. Basically giving me a whole new avenue, a new stream of clientele I would never even have considered targeting by myself. Hopefully as my friend's channel grow, I get to do more cool stuff like this for him. Or for others. He already messaged me that eventually he's going to need some key point art, and some badges as well. God knows what those things are. But I'm willing to find out. Guys, if you enjoy this kind of content, feel free to join our creative crew. We aim to give you 2 videos every week about art, design, illustration, interior design, architecture, all those cool things and everything we can find in between them. As always, leave a like if you enjoyed this one, and I'll hope to see you this time next week. Bye!